I read somewhere that the most important element of war is the use of spies and decoys. Because upon a spy lies the ability for the army to move. And with the decoy lies the element of surprise, which is half the battle.
Hey, baby, what's happening? Hey, are you ready to come back?
On August 10th, 1990, about 2:30 p.m., I was spied with a homegirl Pumpkin and another young lady in her father's truck. They, it, will become our Trojan horse. Forced to play the role she did in the killing, which we all know that ain't true. You, 9 times out of 10, she got a baby by one of your enemies. And don't run out of gas. Attended my first gang funeral, I had a dad home. And it was kind of strange because I felt for him like I would my own mother or father. I was sad and angry at the same time. That made it easy for the older homies to talk me into riding with the drive-by party that night. America calls it propaganda. It's the same technique they use on U.S. soldiers in Vietnam. I mean, how else can you get people to kill perfect strangers they never met? I've been asked to tell you the war story that landed me in this hellhole for 25 years to life.
Strange, I wasn't gonna bang no more. fools looking in my eyes, visualizing a homo. It ain't going down, too many cops around. But when I saw the police smile, I frown. They trying to put me in a twist, but it ain't gonna fly. I know a nigga got it, down the ride. Good, I'm hooked.
Give it up.
It's strange, you got a gang bang to stay alive. Gotta put it down and maintain to survive. Ain't nothing but banging on these South Central streets. And the one gang to watch is the police. It's strange, you got a gang bang to stay alive. Gotta put it down and maintain to survive. Ain't nothing but banging on these South Central streets. And the one gang
I wasn't sure how to feel when I found out he had a Bible. Some say it must have been his time. For him to run out of gas in that particular place at that particular time. I say God decides who lives and dies, not Bloods and Crips.
All right, Shalom. First of all, giving all praises, glory, and honor to the Heavenly Father and His Son, Yahweh Shem Yahushua Barakatah. Double honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone, and much love, peace, and blessing to you elect brothers out there pushing this truth. I'm sure some of y'all have seen this little this little fake video Polite put together with these so-called gang members. Now, what you fail to realize, Polite, is some of us brothers that's in this troop has been involved in street gangs once upon in their life. So we know how street gangs operate, you know what I'm saying, even when they call themselves having a truce or uniting. One thing about it, I know from personal experience, when there's a so-called Blood and Crip uniting, the call has to be made from California on down to recognize that unification of Bloods and Crips. See what I'm saying? And then too, you call yourself uniting as Bloods and Crips, you will never catch a Blood throwing up Crip hand signs, and you will never catch a Crip throwing up Blood hand signs. Because what if something pop off while you call yourself trying to unite, and then you Bloods and Crips are at each other's throat again in the same damn building? Just like on that video. Now what if a fight was to break out between a Blood and a Crip? Is that Blood still gonna be throwing up Crip hand signs, or is that Crip still gonna be throwing up Blood hand signs? Hell nah, cause now they're enemies once again. See what I'm saying? Polite, we see through this bullshit. You done reached to your ultimate low by involving niggas into a spiritual battle. You see what I'm saying? You done paid these niggas off to come up here and promote your wickedness, man. We know these niggas is paid off. These ain't no real gang members, man. You see what I'm saying? Or if they is real gang members, they just took a couple of dollars just to make your little video, trying to make you look good like you a OG. But you're not an OG. Because if you was a real gang member, why you ain't go back to the gang members you hung out with back, where is that, in New York? Did you call yourself a so-called Gorilla Crip? That five-star Gorilla Crip, that you had so many people scared of you because who you was? Well, how come you ain't go get your old goons from the old days? If you were such a gangster, why you have to pay somebody to make a video for you? Because these niggas really don't watch Black News or Sonetta TV. You see what I'm saying? These niggas could care less. And these niggas are hypocrites. These same gang members that you got on this video is hypocrites. And I'm going to tell you why they hypocrites. Number one, in the streets, when you're selling dope, who is it always trying to come up against you? You see what I'm saying? Or outdo you, or try and take your business away from you. It's other niggas. When you're selling dope to somebody, or you buying your dope from another person, who is it always shortchange you on your dope or your money? Another nigga. It ain't the white man. Yeah, the white man put the dope out here in the streets for you dumbass niggas to sell. But when it all boils down, who tries to get over on who? The niggas. Who was always setting their homeboy up to get robbed and killed so he could get that money and power? Niggas. When somebody come up short on their money to pay the dope man, who is it to get their ass whooped? Niggas. When they doing drive-bys because somebody feel like they done disrespected him or his set or his girl or came up short on his money, he owed this nigga $20 for some dope. Who is it they do a drive-by on? Niggas. It's never the white man. But we, spiritual men, we come out and tell the white man to his face that he's the devil, that he's the reason why all these things are happening, that he's the reason for black-on-black crime. Because back in the day, couldn't none of y'all niggas afford an AK-47? Where you think you got it from? The white man. You see what I'm saying? On an unarmed, unmanned train, a boxcar train filled with ammunition for you niggas with the doors wide open, all it took was one nigga say, damn, all these guns? And took them guns, took it back to his hood for his other homeboys to see, and they went to go get guns, and other niggas came and got guns. You see what I'm saying? Because back in the day, niggas couldn't afford an AK-47. We were living off of food stamps. You see what I'm saying? But you the same niggas that call, that say you want to bang on us because we called a black woman a bitch or say fuck Mike Brown or Trayvon Martin. But you the same wicked ass niggas that's out here selling dope to Mike Brown and Trayvon Martin and calling your wife or girlfriend a bitch because she done pissed you off. You them same goddamn wicked ass niggas that a car flashed by just cause you don't like the color he got on, you flashing gang signs ready to pull your pistol out. You them same hypocrite ass niggas, man. Whether you call yourself a fucking Crip or Blood, you them same goddamn hypocrite niggas talking about, well, yeah, we want a bank. When we see it, ain't gonna be no questions. Nah, there ain't gonna be no questions, nigga. Cause we already know what's on your mind. Bullshit, you got demons on your mind. And if you come with that bullshit, we'll beat your motherfucking ass. You see what I'm saying? But we spiritual men. We trying to tell y'all who y'all enemy, because you don't even know who the enemy is. You think the enemy is this Crip, which is your brother, that stay down the block from you. Everything is set up by design, you dumbass niggas. Why you think the white man has you banging red or banging blue? You see what I'm saying? Red and blue represents what? Out with the old ways of life, meaning the Constitution, and bringing in the new ways of life, meaning the new world order, nigga. For you dummies out there, man, call yourself hardcore gangsters, and even in some of y'all Crip and Blood knowledge, it refers back to the Bible. Crip knowledge refers back to who? King David and King Solomon. That's in y'all goddamn Crip prayer. Where you think you get that from? The Bible. But you want to bang against the men of the Lord that's preaching the Bible. Even some of you blood laws, where it come from? The Bible. Where you think all this organization and rules and laws and statutes and commandments come from? This book right here, the Bible. See what I'm saying? Even some of the blood laws, you're not supposed to disrespect an elder. You're supposed to respect the church. Yes. I know about the blood laws. I used to be involved in that, nigga. And it wasn't nothing but bullshit. Why? Because you killing your brother over a fucking color, man, that you don't even own. And then two, on the spiritual side, not the religious, but the spiritual side of the colors, nigga, blue represents what? Royalty. Red represents what? Sacrifice. You know what I'm saying? You dumbass niggas. Sacrifice for who? How about shooting out a shot? You niggas don't understand shit, man. But you going around here call yourself bagging up polite because he done gave you a couple of bucks. You niggas better stop and realize what you're doing, man, because you getting your ass involved in some shit you won't be able to get out of that you don't even understand, man. It goes deeper than what polite telling you, man. This is a spiritual battle. Your how about shooting out a shot would kill you niggas, man. I mean kill you and your family. You see what I'm saying? The same little niggas running around the street you got doing dirt, going to pull robberies and shit just to show your affiliation with these bunch of knucklehead niggas that call yourself a gang, whether you a cripple or blood. But you call yourself wanting to come against the men of the Lord that's out here preaching the Bible, telling our people what's right and what's wrong, trying to rebuild our people, you know what I'm saying, mentally letting them know who they are according to the Bible. And not walk around calling themselves some old blood or Crip. But you niggas are hindering the word, man. Polite is finna get y'all niggas killed. I'm talking directly to you niggas that call yourself gangbangers, man. Polite is finna get you niggas killed. So you better stop and wake up and realize what the hell you done got yourself involved in making that video. first scripture we're going to go to is Proverbs 1 and 10. I'll bring out a couple of scriptures right quick. On you game niggas, you so-called fake-ass game bangers. This is Proverbs 1 and 10. It says, my son, if sinners entice thee, consentest thou not. Meaning polite is trying to entice y'all to bang on the men of the Lord. Don't get yourself involved with it, man. Tell him, hell no. You tell him, look, you stick with your little Egyptology shit, we gonna stick with our street shit. We not finna mess with no men that's preaching the Bible, man. That's going against the Heavenly Father and the Son. Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. Y'all better wake y'all dumb ass up, man. If they say, verse 11, if they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood, meaning what? Yeah, we gonna wait and go and approach them niggas and we gonna kill them niggas just cause they say the black woman is a bitch. You know what I'm saying? Or they saying fuck Mike Brown or fuck Trayvon Martin. Yeah, fuck them wicked ass niggas, man. Is you gonna shake the hand of a crackhead who break in your house and steal your shit? Or is you gonna still keep dating a bitch and keep fucking her after she done set you up to get robbed and tell these niggas where your stash is? Is you gonna call her your black queen or is you gonna call her a bitch? Be for real, man. Wake the fuck up. It says, if they say, come with us, let us wait for blood. Let us lurk privately for the innocent without cause. That's what you niggas doing, or that's what you call yourself trying to do. Ride on the men of the Lord, which means you lurking privately for the innocent without cause. So you call yourself trying to do a who ride on us, a drive-by on the innocent without cause. What's your cause for doing that to us? Have we done anything to you dumbass niggas? Hell no, but tell y'all the truth. Like Galatians 4 and 16 said, have we therefore become your enemy because we tell you the truth? So you niggas better wake up, man, before the Lord kill y'all, man. And quit following this nigga Polite, because he leading y'all down the road of destruction. Why? Because Polite is a wicked ass nigga. He's an old bitch ass pussy worshiping ass nigga, man. And he gonna get y'all killed, man. This is Proverbs 6 and 18. I'll bring out a couple of scriptures right quick. Proverbs 6 and chapter 18. It says, These 16 do what the Lord hate. Yea, 7 are an abomination unto him. Alright, a proud look. Polite, you got a proud look. A lying tongue, you lying on us. Talking about we impregnate 9-year-old kids to these fake-ass gang members. It said, and hands that shed innocent blood. We ain't done nothing to y'all niggas. We ain't did no drive-by on y'all niggas. Only thing we did was gun y'all down with these scriptures. That's it. With this book right here. And it says, a heart, meaning your mind, that devises wicked imagination. That's what you're doing, Polite, to these gang members. You putting evil thoughts in their mind so they can react and try and carry out your wicked agenda. It says, feet that be swift and running to mischief. Just like when there's a fight. What do niggas always do? Run to the fight. And then they get involved without knowing the reason or cause behind the fight. Or just because, see, I even know too, being involved with gangs, you also have gang members that's known as liars. It could be homeboy from your own set. I've experienced this from hell, niggas from my own set. You know what I'm saying? Say, blood, man, I just got jumped by 4 niggas, which he's lying. He just got his ass whooped by 1 nigga, but because he lose the fight and he think he got a reputation to uphold, he come and get y'all, knowing y'all gonna go fight for him or gonna kill this nigga for him. And the whole time he lying. He got his ass whooped by 1 nigga, but he come a lot of y'all say, blood, hey man, these 8 niggas just jumped me, man. I just got jumped by 9 Crips. You see what I'm saying? But it wasn't number 1 nigga, he wasn't even a Crip. He just had on a blue shirt. He don't even game bang. And this nigga beat your ass. But then you come to the hood and lie. Tell me, say, blood, I just got jumped by 20 Crips. The story always change. You see what I'm saying? So you gang members, wake the fuck up, man, because I know you got niggas in y'all set that do that shit, man. Come and lie and shit. Yeah, man, I just got through riding on these Crips. Knowing you ain't do a damn thing, man. You rolled by some Crips, or you might have walked by some Crips, or some Crips might have walked by some blood and ain't said a damn thing. You might even denied your set. Say cuz, or say blood, what set you from? Man, I don't even bang. You see what I'm saying? Y'all niggas ain't hard, man. Y'all some hoes, man. This is Romans chapter 3, verse 15. This for you so-called game-banging ass niggas out there. Romans chapter 3, verse 15. It says, I'ma start at verse 13. Well, I'ma start at verse 11. There is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. You niggas ain't seeking after Yahweh by Shem Yahushua. It said, they are all gone out of the way. They are together become unprofitable. Why? Because Yahweh by Shem Yahushua can't use y'all niggas, man. Y'all niggas is on some old pussy worshiping ass, the black woman is God, Egyptology homosexual doctrine. Because that's what Egyptology is all about, is homosexuality. It says, with their tongues they have used deceit. The poison of asp is under their lips. That's right, all you doing is lying and spreading poison to these knucklehead niggas' head to get them to carry out your agenda, because you paid them to do this old weak video, man. We see right through it, polite, you paid these dudes, man. You done reached to the ultimate low. And it said, verse 14, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. That's right, because, hey, we understand what cursing is by calling on the sports or force to do bodily harm to somebody. And that's what you niggas doing. You cursed us saying, yeah, we're going to ride on you niggas and we're going to gun you niggas down. Oh, no, we ain't going to kill y'all. We're going to do you like in the ancient. We're going to round y'all niggas up and stone y'all to death. Well, where you get that from, man? You look like Tazaria's brother, man. The big, tall, brown-skinned nigga with the dreads. You look like Tazaria's brother from ISUPK, man. You see what I'm saying? Where you get that from? You got that from the scriptures, man. Y'all niggas are double-minded, man. That's why the scripture saying, James, a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Y'all niggas not stable. Y'all don't know what y'all want to represent. And then you had the little scary-ass nigga come on the video talking about something. Man, I don't believe in black-on-black crime, but if it come down to it, nigga, this supposed to be war. You don't supposed to, when it's time for war, you don't care who you kill, nigga. You see what I'm saying? That lets us know through the spirit, you niggas ain't real, man. Or if y'all was in gangs, y'all them saying pussy-ass niggas that run when it's time to get down and get with it. It says, their feet are swift to shed blood. And your feet is swift to shed blood. Just because polite paid y'all, now y'all want to act like y'all ready to ride on the men of the Lord. Y'all niggas ain't doing that shit, man. You see what I'm saying? Y'all just making videos to try and make yourself look hard. Look, mama, I got my 5 minutes of fame. Look, baby, I was on YouTube. Look at me. I look like a real gangster, don't I? Y'all niggas act just like them two black dudes on from Malibu's Most Wanted.
Whack. Weak. Of poor quality. Bad. Whack. Your alma mater is whack. This to disrespect, to embarrass this.
Oh, yeah. Woo! Get on, baby.
We are strapped now, brother.
Set these bad boys down.
Uh-huh.
This is exactly what we ordered, huh?
Oh, yeah, man. They got the Glocks, man. They got the Tech-9s. They got the Uzis. Uh-huh. Freeze, sucker!
That's convincing, brother. That's...
Look, they're fake.
Wow, what the hell is that? What's going on with your hair?
Yeah, to check it out, man, my hair. Shonda just did it for me.
Yeah, I see. I see that.
Huh. You hate it, don't you?
No, I don't hate it. It's just that I thought my character was going to have the corn rolls, and that's all.
Okay, I see. I see what it is. You're just jealous. You're just jealous because you didn't think of it first, huh?
Friggin' A, I'm not jealous, all right? I'm an actor, and I would have... You're freaking whack, and don't diss me! Got the gangster gear, my dog.
Okay, cool.
What is so funny?
The way
Halloween. I didn't know it was Halloween. Hey, well, y'all, could you bring me back some candy?
Whatever, dude.
Give me a ride, punker. I will dust your ass.
Nope. Not convincing.
Damn it. Hey,
find your core character, Sean. You are an oppressed black man from the ghetto.
Yeah, I'm having trouble finding this one, man.
Hey, think Tupac.
All right, let me try it again. Just stay.
I see it. Action! Give me a ride, punker. I will dust your ass at a biatch, and I think you got it. Give me a ride, punk, or I will dust your ass, biatch. 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 Cricket. Turn around and do it again. Biatch. Yes.
Tay Diggs and Anthony Anderson. Y'all act just like them off of Malibu's Most Wanted. Behind the cameras, y'all some old nerds, but on camera, you try to act like you gangsters. You see what I'm saying? Be in the mirror practicing trying to look hard and stuff. What's up, nigga? What's up, nigga? That's how y'all be doing, man, because y'all not real. It said, verse 16, destruction and misery are in their ways, and the way of peace have they not known. Y'all don't know nothing about no peace. Talking about y'all having a peace treaty. Y'all uniting. But it ain't number 70 y'all in there. Tell me something. What? We unite, man. But I don't see the rest of the people in the background confirming what y'all doing. They ain't even saying nothing. They back there playing pool and getting drunk. While you fake ass nigga, yeah, we unite. You know what I'm saying? Wouldn't want to, what'd you say? Wouldn't want to see you or be you. But y'all supposed to be Crips and Blood. But y'all throwing up each other hand signs and shit. Y'all dumbass niggas, man. That's how we know it ain't real, man. Next scripture, Isaiah 51 and 20. I'm not going to spend too much time on y'all niggas. I just had to make this quick response because it just vexed my spirit, man. What is it? Isaiah 51 and 20. It says, Isaiah 51 and 20. Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets as a wild bull in the net. And that's how y'all niggas is standing on the corner, man. Flashing gang signs. Can't wait to get into a fight, man. You see what I'm saying? They are full of fury of the Lord, the rebuke of thy power. You see what I'm saying? They fear full of the fear of the Lord on the left-hand side. Why? Because the Lord is using them as weapons to take out wicked niggas, even though y'all are wicked niggas. And at the end, y'all gonna be taken out too. You see what I'm saying? Why y'all think y'all doing a right thing by riding for polite finna get y'all killed, man. Point blank, period. Isaiah 59 and 7. This strictly for y'all wannabe gang members. Isaiah 59 and 7, it says, their feet run to evil, and they make haste to shed innocent blood. Their thoughts are thoughts of iniquity, wasting and destruction are in their paths. That's right, it said, wasting and destruction are in their paths. Nothing good is going to come to y'all wannabe gang members. Why? Because y'all make haste to shed innocent blood. Y'all always quick to shed innocent blood. Say blood or say cuz, that nigga in the wrong hood. Let's kill that nigga. See what I'm saying? And it says, their thoughts are thoughts of iniquity, meaning of sin, transgressing the law. And it said, wasting and destruction are in their path. That's all y'all think about. Yeah, cuz, yeah, blood, we gonna get these niggas, man. Let's go ride on these niggas, cuz. Yeah, blood. That's all y'all think about is wickedness and stupidity, man. Y'all look fucking stupid, man. Sitting up there throwing up gang signs or deaf sign language for the deaf, because it's basically the same fucking thing. Where you from? West side, nigga. Y'all niggas look stupid, man. You see what I'm saying? Wake the fuck up and realize what the white man is doing to y'all, man. Keeping y'all dumb and docile, man. This is 2 Ezra 1 and 26 in the Apocrypha. Second Ezra chapter 1 verse 26. For y'all wannabe gang members, man. Second Ezra 1 and 26. It says, this the second Ezra 1. I was at the first Ezra. Second Ezra chapter 1 verse 26. It says, whensoever ye shall call upon me, I will not hear you. That's right, when another nigga ride down upon you, like, oh God, Jesus, help me. I don't want to die. He's not going to hear you. Why? It said, whensoever ye shall call upon me, I will not hear you, for ye have defiled your hands with blood, and your feet are swift to commit manslaughter. Meaning what? You quick to ride down on the men of the Lord because we say the black woman is not God, or fuck Mike Brown, or fuck Trayvon Martin, or fuck the black woman. You see what I'm saying? You so quick to commit manslaughter, to kill a righteous man for a wicked nigga like Polite, man. And the Lord is going to kill y'all, man. Point blank, period. The Lord is going to destroy each and last and every one of y'all. And anybody else who want to ride with Egyptology or call yourself a gang member, whether you be a Crip, Blood, Vice Lord, GD, Latin King, Sir 13, MS 13, it don't matter, man. Black P-Stone, a Cobra, you know what I'm saying? It don't matter, man. Yehovah Shemiah Rashad is going to destroy y'all, man. Whether you call yourself a Pyru, it don't matter. The Lord is going to destroy you. You see what I'm saying? So all you niggas out there that call yourself gang members or trying to ride for Polite and don't know what you're riding for them for, you better get your goddamn mind right before you holler by Shemiah Rashad come and destroy you fake-ass wannabe gang members out there, man. You see what I'm saying? So the next time you call yourself sitting at home on the corner, what's that, nigga? You better realize what the fuck you doing, man. You sitting up there throwing up satanic hand signs and don't even know it. You see what I'm saying? What's a crypt? That's a burial place, a tomb, a grave. See what I'm saying? Blood. What you doing? You throwing up the triple sixes, man. By throwing up your blood hand sign. Even you Pyrus, you throwing up what? Baphomet. See what I'm saying? GD, what you throwing up? The pitchfork goes back to who? The Greek god who? Poseidon, the trident. You better realize what the fuck you doing. You vice lords. You throwing up what? Baphomet. Well, you trying to do your little VL hand signs? Yeah. Or IVL? You throwing up what? Baphomet. Even you Latin king, you throwing up Baphomet. See what I'm saying? So y'all better realize what the fuck you doing, man. All this is set up by design by who? The white man. To conquer and destroy you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. The real children of Israel, man. You see what I'm saying? So y'all better get y'all goddamn mind right before y'all destroy. And Polite, you might as well give up, man. You're not going to get nobody to ride on us. Because like the scriptures say, hey, there's no enchantment against Jacob. And you can't do his prophets no harm. You see what I'm saying? You can't put no spells or try to call somebody on us, man. Yehovah Shemiah Rashad is protecting us. And we're not scared of you niggas, man. You see what I'm saying? Hey, I fear no man and very few animals. You get what I'm saying? The only man I do fear is Yehovah Shemiah Rashad. I don't fear you Polite, and I don't fear them fake-ass gang members that you got in your video, man. And with that, hey, all praise to Yehovah Shemiah Rashad. Hey, double honors to the elder apostle, Great Millstone, and much love to you real brothers out there, you elect brothers out there that's pushing this truth through the strength and power of Yehovah Shemiah Rashad. Hey, don't let that video Polite rattle y'all, man. You know what I'm saying? Stay strong, keep pushing his word. So what if a gang member roll up on us? Guess what? Our angels are encamped around about us. So there's no reason for us to fear these niggas. You bang on these niggas with the scriptures. Now, if they try and swing on you, hey, then that's something different. But I know me personally, I'm going to bang these niggas with the scriptures. Now, if they want to take it to the street, hey, we go to the street, and I'm going to still come back and bang on them with the scriptures. See what I'm saying? Cause that's what my faith and trust rely on is Yehovah Shimei Shah, and not no goddamn punk ass gun or some punk ass fucking color like red and blue. You see what I'm saying? So with that, hey, Shalom, Kwame Ashali, get y'all mind right.
Now we can settle this like you got some class, so we can get into some gangster shit.
You shade tree nigga. You ain't no pimp. You're a rest haven for hoes. You're a car thief. A car thief. The one you got out there is probably hot as a firecracker right now.
It was $35,000.
Right? $35,000 cash money?
No, I get $35,000 plus one, right?
The one I gave you.
No, you gave me six, though, right?
That's
it was
true.
One, I had one, it was six, and $35,000 plus one plus six leaves seven. $35,000 and seven, right? Motherfucker, can you buy that?
Nigga, next time you hear grown folks talking, shut the fuck up, here. Go get it, Bob. Bring that bitch here.
Freeze, nigga. You wanna die.
Is this where you gonna be, man?
She'll pay.
I'm gonna make you wish you never was born, nigga. Let's get out of this dump.